wooden and stuff. It's got that super cowboyish feel. This is actually where you enter to go into the hotel, which we will be going up here in just a minute, but there's something I'll show you first in the lobby.
They're everywhere.
This is worth millions of because of the dates on those coins.
What do you guys think of this place?
I think it's fantastic.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Like, that thing's gnarly. It's huge too, huh?
It is.
You wouldn't expect that to be as tall as it is.
No, it's mind blowing actually. Come here. Oh. Is that your main man?
That's my main squeeze.
Your main squeeze. You guys make a cute couple.
Thanks.
Check out this dude.
What does the hat say? The ladies love my haunting looks, the ghoulish style, and the creepy things I whisper in their ear. Oh, you whisper, huh?
Here, let him whisper something in your ear. Get close, Kara.
Okay.
What is he telling you?
I'm done.
What?
I didn't hear you.
Oh, really?
Ooh. Okay, sure, he gives you the juicy stories.
All the juicy details, right?
All of it, yeah. I'm so jealous, you know? She brings out the crazy in people.
This beautiful woman contains 3,261 silver dollars. 3,261 silver dollars. Can you believe that?
And if you ever need it.
What are the dates on these things? Can you get close enough to see?
Yeah, that's why I looked mine up. 1922, 23, 25.
What do you think, Kara?
I think it's awesome.
I'm super excited. It's amazing.
I just wish that this love tester still works. Figure out what's going on.
So heavy in here. I don't know. That would be the best feeling to describe it. It was heavy.
It is very heavy.
And I guarantee something happens behind door 8 because that's just creepy. Door 8 right there. Whoa.
You can't be doing that to me. Sorry, bro. That's messed up, Jeff. Be off. All right.
I bet something comes crawling under that chimney, too.
Look at the craftsmanship of this chair. Like, oh,
something comes crawling under the chimney?
The way that they did things back in the 1800s is so much better than the way we do it today. I'm just being honest. I think that the 1800s, they put so much craftsmanship into everything that they did.
It does.
So this is where we're going to be investigating tonight, and I'm going to take you upstairs now to the hotel rooms where we're staying, where activity is reported to happen all the time. There's a spirit prostitute supposedly slit her wrist along with other spirits that we're going to try and contact. So let's go up there. I'll show you guys around. You got the door?
Yep.
Okay.
Got
this huge flipping staircase. And it's super creepy. It is a little bit creepy for sure. Obviously, the reason this place is haunted is it was on the Ghost Adventures documentary. And the door I'm standing by, this is room 11. This is where Zach Bagans stayed inside with Nick. They caught some weird activity and supposedly a prostitute slit her wrist right here in this room. I have stayed in this room with Jeff, and we had weird stuff happen. In fact, I had a buddy who bought a camera just to come here and film, and his camera died only in this room, and it never worked again. I'm dead serious, it really happened. Then another staircase that goes up here. Right up there. I'm gonna take you guys to where we're staying. Why don't you guys show me your room? You got a pretty pink room, right?
We do, and it smells wonderful.
It smells lovely.
So this is gonna be one of the rooms. This is the pretty pink room.
Oh, it smells really good in here, actually.
It does.
Did you guys add that, or is that...
No, I always like that when we get in.
What?
Yeah.
We so fart
really. Why don't we get, like, pink, pink princess smell?
No, we get the smell of your ass.
Oh, dude, no.
This is
that.
What my ass smells
That's going
like
in, baby. What did you just say?
So that's the smell of our ass. That we toot roses.
Just a typical K2, which we're going to use. And then you also have the puck. And the puck is...
Wow.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. Yay. And then, I don't know about you guys, but I brought my fidget spinner. And then on top of that, I'm going to be using Echo Box. So we've got all the bases covered. And basically what I want to do is I kind of want to start downstairs in the lobby. And then we're going to work our way back up here and see if we can have any spiritual encounters. So, are you guys ready to do this?
Yep.
Yeah.
Let's go down to the lobby.
This is the chapel, and it's just such weird, dark energy in here. It just feels ominous.
It does.
Yeah, it does.
Oh, is it getting hit already?
No, that's your camera. That's why I didn't bring mine. Because
the camera? Why would
yeah,
I
your
camera?
Light. My camera.
It's still going off. Why would my light cause electromagnetic frequency?
Sometimes the cameras do. Or the light.
No, it's not now.
It's not the
what?
Camera.
That's weird.
Look at this. We're
getting... Oh, wow.
I don't know what that is. That's weird. Okay, Paramaniacs. This device right here picks up electromagnetic frequencies. So you can get a lot of false positives from like your telephone, and there's all kinds of stuff that can cause that to go off. She thinks it might be the camera, and she could actually be right. It just doesn't seem to go off when we're putting the camera close. So I don't know what that was. So Jeff kind of set it over here on this pedestal, and we'll see if we can get it to go off. But that was really odd.
That was odd.
Is there anybody in here right now? Any spirits that can hear our voice?
If you're here, can you touch that and let us know?
There's another little cool thing right here, a gold-colored device, which which will spin. Is that me? Every time I go close, that thing goes off. I'm going to back up. If you spin that gold-colored device, if you hit it really hard, it'll spin. There's all kinds of stuff going on right now, guys. We're having to investigate in the daytime, which makes it really hard because of what happened last night. So there's a television on I can hear in the background, there's people, so it's really hard to get like collective, strong evidence, but we have to at least try, we have to try. And there's some weird stuff going on with K2, we don't know exactly what that is. It just feels weird in here, I just
it
feel
does.
Weird.
It does. I'm gonna turn, yeah, let's do the REM pod.
Yeah.
Where do you want me to put this?
Why don't you actually put the REM pod in place of my... All right. Any spirits, ghosts, energies that may be in here that can hear us? We have some devices that we've told you about. We do have the K2, which I believe you're familiar with. And then just over here, we have what's called a REM pod. And you may see kind of a pointy thing poking out of it, which is called an antenna. If you touch it, it'll light up a bunch of colors and make some noise for us, indicating that you're here. Can you try that, please?
Come on, I know you can do it.
If you want us to leave, we will gladly leave. We're not here to bother you. We just want to know if you're here. Can you touch that? And we will leave if you do. You guys picking up on anything in here? Feeling anything?
It feels heavy.
It does. It feels really heavy.
I think it's weird. It feels heavy for a freaking chapel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right?
Chapel shouldn't feel
a waiting chapel.
Shouldn't feel heavy.
Well, was it anything before? Or sometimes, you know, there's attachments under, like, furniture.
Yeah.
And
yeah, look at all this.
Yeah.
We've got a bunch of old things.
Who knows if that was
original? I don't know. You know what? Let's go back upstairs. It's a little noisy in here. Maybe they want to communicate with us upstairs. It's a little more quiet. They may be intimidated. I don't know. Maybe there's too much going on out there.
You know, we should put the REM pod by where you saw that apparition come out of the wall last night. I think that would be a good idea.
Okay.
That's right there by blood, right?
Yeah, just right there on the bench.
Yeah, on that bench.
All right, let's do it. Good.
All right.
Room 11, just right there, which is where prostitutes lick her wrists. And I'm going to turn on the echo box. I'm gonna turn on the echo box.
Sounds like someone just stepped on the floorboards there, but
mm-hmm. Yeah, no one moved at all.
We have not even moved.
Nope. Hello?
Are you here with us?
Somebody upstairs.
Yeah.
I'm not moving. You guys heard that, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's like someone's freaking standing right next to me.
Well, that's exactly where Tammy saw the gentleman come out of the wall last night, the apparition. Exactly like where you're hearing that and feeling that.
I'm not moving. You guys see that?
Mm-hmm.
You can still hear it.
I see that.
It's not even doing it. What the hell? Look, guys.
And now
I kind of hear it a little bit.
But it's like something.
Let me move
like,
and we'll see. Dude, that was weird.
It's like something's trying to sneak by.
Mm-hmm. We're in the way.
I'm gonna turn the echo box on. I kind of walk around and sweep this and see if we can.
Do you hear that? It sounds like it's walking up there.
Yeah, right there.
Who's here with us? Where do you want us to go?
The spot?
The something.
Yep, the spot, yep.
Wait.
Wait.
The spot, yep.
Wait.
Wait.
The spot, yep.
Wait.
Wait. You think he means right here? Like, wait, right here?
We're gonna leave. What is Jeff sitting on right here?
Did that say?
It keeps saying
Jeff.
Jeff?
I heard my name.
Yeah, I did hear your name. Did you hear that?
No, it said what?
Jeff.
I heard my name.
I could have sworn that's what it said. Maybe we were wrong because you were so far away, but it's literally.
I'm gonna go back over here.
It's.
Put this button.
Yeah.
It's not like I said
Jeff.
I heard my name. Again, Jeff.
What's my name?
Whoa. Did it whisper it?
Their wrist.
What was that?
I have no idea.
Did you stay in room 11?
I thought so.
No.
So you guys, I forgot to tell you that something grabbed my leg at the cemetery. Like, literally grabbed it.
Was it Trey?
Hiding behind a bush.
In a bush.
The minute she walked through the door, da 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 da.